We're now ready for the second of the six big ideas that make up calculus. It's the idea that I call track the changes. So, six pillars of calculus. The first was close is good enough, the idea that we do approximations and then get better approximations and better approximations. So instead of getting an answer in one fell swoop, we do successive approximations. But the second idea is track the changes. If you want to understand anything in the world, look at how it's changing. Our eyes are built for this. If you look straight ahead, everything in your periphery is going to fade out unless something moves there, and then you'll notice it in an instant. And every time that you cross the street, you're tracking changes. You're looking at the cars that are coming. You're figuring out how fast they're moving. What's the rate of change of their position? You're using that rate of change to figure out where they're going to be a few seconds from now. And then you're deciding, do I have enough time to cross the street safely? You've been doing this ever since you were a toddler, and you've gotten really good at it. So let's talk about the math involved. So rate of change is the same as the slope of a line, is the same as a conversion factor. Let's see what I mean by that. Let's suppose you're driving down the road, and at 1 o'clock, you reach mile marker 100. And at 2 o'clock, you reach mile marker 160. And at 3 o'clock, you reach mile marker 220. And let's suppose that you're moving with constant speed. How fast are you moving? And where will you be at 4 o'clock? Now, this is a pretty easy problem. If you plot where you are as a function of time, it's just you get a straight line, and you say, between 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock, let's see, how far did I go? Well, I went from mile marker 100 to mile marker 160, that's 60 miles. So the rise in this line is the change in the output. It's output at the end minus output at the beginning. So delta S, if you call S your distance, we use the Greek letter delta to mean change. Delta S is 60 miles. The run is how long it took. In this case, 1 hour. So delta S is 60 miles, delta T is 1 hour, you're going at 60 miles an hour. Now you could have done it from 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock. Then you would have said, oh, we went 120 miles, 220 minus 100, in 2 hours, 3 minus 1, same ratio. So the speed you're going, that's the rate of change, is the same thing as the slope of the line when you plot it. That's rise over run. And it's also a conversion factor. You might have a passenger call home and say, hey, we're going to be home in time for dinner. Well, how far are you from town? Well, we're about 2 hours away. Well, you're not 2 hours away. You're 120 miles away. But you know that since the change in position divided by the change in time is 60. The change in position is 60 times the change in time. 2 hours is worth 120 miles. Or 120 miles divided by 60 is 2 hours. So you just automatically think, if you're going 60 miles an hour, you automatically think 1 minute equals 1 mile. If you're 10 miles from town, you might say, we're 10 minutes away from town, because you've done the conversion. The conversion, if you were going 30 miles an hour and 10 miles away, you would say, we're 20 minutes from town, because you'd be dividing by 30 instead of dividing by 60. So the speed gives you a conversion between changes in time and changes in position. The same thing goes in general. In general, whenever you have a function that's evolving linearly, the change in the output is the rate of change times the change in the input. So if you take the change in the output over the change in the input, which is a slope, that's the same thing as the rate of change. So the rate of change is a conversion factor, and it's also a slope. That's for things that go in a straight line. In our next video, we'll talk about things that aren't in a straight line.